IRA owners often name their spouse as the beneficiary of their IRA. This gives the surviving spouse the ability to place the inherited IRA in their own IRA. A spouse is part of a group of people known as eligible designated beneficiaries who can utilize a very powerful tax-deferring benefit called a stretch IRA. However, leaving your IRA to your spouse may be a problem if they remarry. The caution here is that assigning your spouse as the beneficiary may lead to disinheriting your children. Let's walk through a hypothetical situation. Mary and John are married and in their 60s. Both have large, regular IRAs. They name each other as the primary beneficiary and their children as contingent beneficiaries. Mary passes away, and John, as the spousal beneficiary of Mary's IRA, can then place her IRA into his IRA and stretch both IRAs over his lifetime. Later, John falls in love and soon thereafter remarries. Wanting to provide for his new wife, John names her as the primary beneficiary of his IRA, an IRA that now contains both his and Mary's money. John's new wife promises that should he pass away first, she will be certain that the assets of John's IRA go to Mary and John's children. John passes away, and his IRA is now passed to his wife from the second marriage. His second marriage's wife can name anyone she wants as the beneficiary of her new IRA. She names her own children as primary beneficiaries, thus bypassing Mary and John's children completely, and effectively disinheriting them from one of Mary and John's largest assets. This hypothetical situation is not all that uncommon and is a very unfortunate occurrence to the children from the first marriage. Luckily, there is something that can be done to avoid this unintended outcome. Instead of John naming his new wife as the income beneficiary of his IRA, John could consider establishing a DTC IRA Special Situations Trust and naming the trust as the beneficiary of his IRA. In his IRA trust, John would name his new wife as the beneficiary and provide that she receives the required minimum distributions, RMD, for her lifetime. His trust would also specify that when his second wife dies, the trust assets revert back to Mary and John's children, thereby allowing John to provide for his new wife, but assuring that the assets go back to the rightful heirs for these assets, Mary and John's children. Having the money in a DTC IRA Special Situations Trust may also protect the assets from irresponsible spending from the second spouse, possible financial manipulation of the spouse by his or her family, creditors, lawsuits, and bankruptcy. To learn more about protecting your IRA, eliminating the Secure Act tax at the end of the 10th year, or ways of replacing IRA assets lost to taxes, contact us today. Be sure to subscribe to our channel for more Dunham Insights.